Welcome to Radical Underdogs. Today we're talking about the cheap end of motorsport and exactly how much that costs. If you've ever dreamed about getting on track racing, the MX-5 Clubman Championship is one of the cheapest championships in the UK, racing on international circuits. Now, I've previously talked about getting into racing. This is about how much the 2023 season costs for me. This isn't just about the numbers, it's a glimpse into the reality of racing. And it might just help you decide if this adrenaline-fueled journey is the one you're looking for. Keep in mind, this is just my experience. Your mileage might vary. I ran in 6 out of the 8 weekends, and really importantly, I did this without paying for team support. Let's dive in. First up, race entry fees, the heartbeat of racing, coming in at around £2,500. This covers the fees from the BRSCC for running the races. A lot of that ends up going into the coffers of MSV, who are the track operators for most of the tracks in the UK. And there's a small bit in there for getting the all-important racing license from Motorsport UK. Now coming on to testing and track day fees, where I managed to save some money this year. MSV test day prices have skyrocketed well above inflation in the last few years, and are now above the price of racing itself. The cost of a one-day test is about £400, and that's only 2 hours of track time split into sessions. So I've opted for a few Thursday evening track days this year at around £100 a pop. And even though there are some more restrictions on timing and overtaking, I think it is worthwhile. However, those days weren't available every weekend, and it wasn't ideal going into qualifying without any testing at all. But it did keep the budget in check, and it cost me around £1,500 for the year. Damage repair, the not so glamorous side of racing. Reshelling the car after Silverstone set me back about £1,300. But it involved a lot of sweat equity from me and others who helped me out. Maintenance and upgrades added another sort of £1,300 to the tally. Racing without a team is not just about speed, it's about resilience and spanner time. Fuel, you can't race without it. You also can't get to the track without it. With a thirsty American V6 in the Jeep Cherokee and a slightly less thirsty but full throttle MX-5, we spent over £1,000 on fuel this year. Talking about the Jeep, it also went wrong again this year and cost me over £500 in maintenance. Tyres are controlled in this championship, which means you can only go to one supplier. They aren't too expensive as motorsport tyres go, but we still spent over £800 on tyres this year. My team is mostly paid in bacon sandwiches and coffees at very expensive cafes at racetracks. Over the year, this added up to around £500. I prefer to drive to or camp at the tracks, so I only have one hotel bill this year, although that could easily add up. Style matters both on and off the track, but you wouldn't think it from how the car looks now. At the start of the year, we did do some cosmetic work, changed the colour and put a new livery on it. All that came in at just under £300. We're now onto the minor things here and there. The Transponder subscription is a great example of monopoly pricing for any budding economic students out there. So what does that come to for the year? Are we over budget? I set the budget at around £10,000 for the year. So drum roll please. And we came in at around £10,563.18. So pretty much on budget then. But it was pretty expensive. But what does that buy you as an alternative in the motoring world? Well, maybe you'd take a Tesla Model Y on a lease, or maybe you'd splash out on a 15-year-old Porsche 911. I don't know, but will either of those things offer you this?